Namaskar. Knee pain is very, very common. It could be physical injury, inflammation, or basically arthritic condition. As we grow, our body gets into an arthritic condition, more wear and tear and more problems. But wear and tears don't cause the problem. The problem is because of stress and tension. Wear and tear is a common management. If it gives you pain, then somewhere some other reason is there. Maybe we hit very often, give injury here and there while rushing and walking here and there. Or there is some inflammation because of many other reasons, water retention in body or other organs not functioning so well. Or generally weight, which is creating more problem. Pain could be mild, pain could be moderate, and with both these things it can be easily managed at home with your own self, with your own effort. So here are few remedies to overcome the pain. First, asanas to release the knee pain. You need to strengthen your leg muscles to reduce the pressure on your knee, and following asanas will do exactly this to reduce the pain. First among the asanas is Hastapad Angushthasana. It could be done with one leg, both the legs, and with different sides also. So you can call it that Hastapad Angushthasana twist variation, when you are lifting your right leg going to the other side. Other asanas could be Yastikasana, Talasana, and Shavasana. Talasana, when you do to reduce knee pain, you are supposed to keep both the feet firm on the ground, not raise on the toe, and do the Talasana. That would be beautiful. Shavasana is a relaxing posture, and there is a rule in yoga that whenever you get any pain in any joint, that joint should be relaxed well. First relaxation for 2 days and then strengthening of everything. Pain may be there, pain may not be there, but first relaxation for 2 days. And when you are relaxing, try to see that you give little warmth to that area, to see that you use hot water bag in that area, or you sit in sun, keeping your back in the sun. All that would help in relaxing, and then you can start strengthening your muscles. One must also know the kind of asanas which you should avoid completely. Avoid all the asanas which involve bending of your knee. When you bend your knee, you are giving strain and stress to your body, and so avoid these asanas totally. Here are those asanas: Utkatasana, Vakrasana, Ushtrasana, Virabhadrasana, Sukhasana. Could be done if pain is little mild, and do it for 2 minutes, not more than that. Pavanamuktasana can be done by holding thigh instead of knee, and it could be done nicely. Second point, postural correction. How you carry yourself, how you carry your posture whole day, definitely plays a very great significance in this problem of knee. So here, understand, do not sit for long with knee bent. When you are sitting on chair, your knees are bent. And so try and keep your legs up, elevate your legs, put them straight in front of you, little above your hip level, and that would help not hurting your knee. Make sure that you are not sitting for long. You are walking every half an hour, little bit here and there, and then sitting and doing the work. Most important is when you are traveling, say example in train or in car, understand that you keep your feet in such a position that you don't waver, don't give weight on one leg. Both legs should have equal weight of your body. And when you are sitting in the car, just see that instead of hanging your leg down, fold the other leg, which has no pain, up, so that you can sit more at the level of thigh than on your back. And this is how you will help your knee. Preferably use Western toilet rather than Indian toilet. Even in Western toilet, when the seat is low, that will cause more pain. So seat has to be little at height. An additional seat has to be put on a Western toilet so that you can sit easily and get up easily. Whenever you have to stand, See to it that your position is proper. Both legs have to be away. Preferably stand with 2 feet away. Both the foot should be away from each other and really 2 feet away. Then standing would be better. Adjust your leg in such a way that your body's weight is equal on both the legs. Such a position will not hurt your knee, otherwise it is going to hurt. Third point, when the pain is there, what is required is hot pack as well as cold pack. When you use hot water bag on your joint, give warmth to your body, then it relaxes the muscles and the lubricant increases. The lubrication between two joints improves and that helps in releasing the pain. So we should use hot water bag or hot pad, anything to improve the circulation in that region. Cold package always reduces the inflammation and swelling. So there is a very strong rule that whenever you injure your joints, after injury, immediately use cold pack, not hot water bag. Use cold pack because any arteries, if they are burst, they would clog and the swelling would reduce. But after 1 day, after 24 hours, then start using hot water bag. Above all these are the theories, but above all, your body itself will tell you what suits your body later on. With cold pack, understand that don't apply ice directly. It would be a shock for your skin and everything. Apply cold pack and that would be beautiful. Fourth point, for knee pain, you should lose your weight. Whatever weight you have, you may be thin and skinny also, but reduce little bit more weight to help your pain. When person has excess body weight, then that gives a very, very heavy load on your knee. Nothing else is going to help you. You have to work on your weight. So have that type of a lifestyle, that type of a diet to see to it that slowly, slowly, slowly you are reducing your weight. Not suddenly, it's going to create problem in other organs of our body. To reduce weight, person must do walking, person must do exercise, and person must be very much aware about the diet. See to it that whatever you eat only little to sustain, not to fill your stomach. Eat only when you are hungry and eat little to satiate your hunger, not to fill your stomach. So if you eat 4 times in a day, little food, and in between twice fruits, and be very strict with your hunger and the quantity of food, then you will definitely reduce your weight, excess will go, and your health will improve. Fifth, so some dietary remedies are here. One must consume sufficient amount of fruits and vegetables as they contain antioxidants and anti-inflammatory compounds. All this is going to reduce the inflammation and so the pain. Berries, apples, peanuts, grapes and pomegranate should be there in your daily meal. All this helps in fighting arthritis. Totally avoid non-vegetarian food. Again, avoid sugary and salty food. Avoid processed foods. These readily packets where preservatives are put, artificially colored, flavored things are there. All these things are going to increase your arthritic condition. Add more whole grains to your diet. For example, replace brown rice instead of white rice. Brown rice, hand-pounded rice, parboiled rice are far better, and you should make all the dishes of rice with these things, not with polished rice. Similarly, in wheat products, totally avoid products made out of maida. So all these things like bread and all bakery products, cakes and pastries, all these things could be avoided. In fact, let me tell you, brown rice can really help in preventing joint issues. Avoid eating lentils every day. Rather, have sprouts twice in a week. More lentils, more high protein food is going to affect your joints. Avoid oil containing omega-6 fatty acids like sunflower oil and even vegetable oil. So take rice bran oil, take ghee, in small quantity and see that your joint is properly lubricated. Another oil which is really good is olive oil. Consume that. It is excellent in anti-inflammatory property. Sixth point, relax your mind. A stiff mind leads to stiff joints, directly connected. The moment you are angry, disturbed, the moment you have very rigid opinions, what happens? Muscles become tight, joints come closer, more wear and tear of joints starts, and more arthritic condition comes in. So be very, very clear. Whenever there is a pain in joints, the first thing you should do is to relax your mind, remove all the rigidity from your mind, remove the negativity from your mind, and that itself will help you to overcome the pain. Knee joint pain has to be attended, and really attended seriously. Otherwise, it is going to cause extra pressure on all other joints, and it is going to cause severe pain, which would remain for a longer period continuously. Hence, it is highly important to keep your mind peaceful and joyful all the time. Practice these following techniques to relax. You must learn to relax intermittently in a day and see to it that your mind is not continuously under pressure. Here are the techniques called as Nishpanda Bhav, Shavasana, and any meditative technique done any time in a day, done so regularly that you are always in a relaxed state. Our knees have to be strengthened all the time. Strong knee will be carrying you throughout the day, standing, sitting, walking, running, climbing. Knees have to be strong, and so take care of your knee. When the knees are weak, that would affect your whole system. Your heart is going to suffer because you can't walk, you can't climb. Person will get into diabetic state because again, no physical activity of walking, climbing. So just understand that a good health of your knee is a must for the entire body and for your life. So take care. All these things which we have mentioned, just do them. Just see that you are very serious about this pain. Very often we have observed that when people are suffering from pain, they say, okay, now pain will remain in body, what is there? But don't neglect that. It is going to increase if you don't take care. And so be very, very clear that you have to take care of your health, your total health, and so your knees. Take care. Namaskar.